What's going on, y'all? Welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be talking about some of my favorites I've been pretty much loving for the whole year 2018. And I only have 10, I think I have like 10 products, and I'm just gonna go ahead and get started. The first thing that's been my absolute favorite are my lashes from AliExpress. As y'all already know, I only buy my lashes from AliExpress, and I get them from the Visofree official store. And my favorite style of lashes is the D22s. Kind of what these look like. Super cute. These are really, really long lashes, and I love them. I just love how full they are, but they're not too full. I love how they're just really nice and fluttery, and it's just, these are just really pretty lashes, y'all. These are only like $2 and some change, $2.50, something like that, on the AliExpress website. But these are the style D22. This is in the style E11. As you can see, these are not as full. So this is D22. As you can see, these are really full lashes, super cute. And this is E11. These are really cute too, just not as long and full as the D22. But these are really nice. The only thing you have to do is just kind of trim off the ends to keep the ends from, you know, poking you. But other than that, these are really nice lashes. For $2, these are really good. So my next favorite is my Fenty foundation. And this is my Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Foundation in the shade 440. I love this foundation. It's the one I'm wearing now. It's amazing. I love that it's a matte finish. And I love that, I love the way it looks. It just really, I love the way this foundation looks, y'all. It just, I'm able to build it up. It's not really a full coverage foundation, but I feel like you are able to kind of build it up. I put on maybe like two, three layers. I put on the first layer, and then I do have a breakout right here. You can probably see it through my makeup right here. That's giving me problems, and it just won't go away. But I put on like two, maybe three layers of it, and I blended that out. I blended it out with my beauty sponge, and it covered it up no problem. I didn't have to go over it with like a heavy concealer or nothing like that. So I do feel like you're able to build up this foundation, but I love it. It's a lightweight finish, and I love that it has a pump. I love this foundation. Absolutely amazing. So my next product I'll be talking about is my Maybelline Fit Me powder. I love these powders. This is in the color 35 deep. I do wish they had a shade in between 35 and 40, because I feel like 40 is a little bit off for me, and I use this one for my under eyes, so I wish they had a shade like in between, maybe like a few shades in between, you know, for like as an all over powder. But I love this powder, and I use this all the time for my under eyes, and it really keeps me from having like that ghostly look, or that super light under eye highlight that I really don't like. It keeps me from having that. And then when I put it under my eyes, I'm able to let it sit for a little bit longer because of the color. It's not as pale. It's really, really nice. I like this. And I want to say it was like $8, something like that from Walgreens. Super affordable. But I really like this powder. This is like my favorite. Okay, now this next powder that I'm going to talk about is not in my favorites video. It's not on my favorites list. But I feel like this will become a favorite. This is my Black Opal powder. And I got the color 600 Dark. And this is what this powder looks like. And I set my face with this today. And this is the Soft Velvet Finishing Powder. And I used it today, and I love it. It's a really nice powder. I feel like, because I recently just got it, I feel like this will definitely become my new favorite powder to set my face with. Alright, so my next favorite I'm going to talk about is my Crayon Case Lip Glosses. I love these lip glosses. They're super cheap. And I got, I actually have three colors, but the two colors that I'm gonna show you today is Clean Kisses and Private Party. I'm wearing Private Party today with Chestnut Lip Liner from MAC. These are super cute, y'all. And I love that, I love the color payoff that you get. That is Clean Kisses. And this is Private Party. Private Party is more of a pink gloss. So that's Private Party and that's Clean Kisses. But yeah, y'all, I love these lip glosses. These are so cute. Okay, so my next favorite that I've been really, really wearing a lot in 2018 is the Juvia's Place eyeshadows. And this is the Magic Mini Palette, and I use this palette a lot. I use this palette so much. And the main colors that I use in this palette is Zakia, which is this really deep orange. This one is Nana. And this one is Burano. So I use Zakiya, Nana, and Baranu probably the most. And I'm actually wearing Baranu now as a highlight here, and the highlight here, super cute. I really, really like this palette. It's really versatile. I like that it has this really deep matte blue, because this is a really, really good color. And this one here is like a deep violet color. It's not quite blue, but not quite purple. It's just kind of right in between. This is just a really cute palette. I love this palette. All right, so my next favorite I'm going to talk about is a body butter. And this is the Body Shop Almond Milk and Honey. And this, I don't think y'all don't understand. I love this body butter. When you put it on your skin, it just looks like, it just makes your skin look so, so healthy and shiny. It's just so, so pretty. I'm going to put some on my hand and show you what it looked like. And it's not oily. It's just, it gives you that shine, that healthy glow on your skin. And it's really, really pretty. I just love the way it makes my skin feel, and I love the way it makes my skin look. This is just, I love this body butter. See it? I don't know if you can really tell, but it just gives your skin that glow. It's super, super cute. I just love the way. And then the smell, I love the way it smells too. It smells, it's almond and honey, but it's like, it's not super sweet. It's a really nice smell. So I love this body butter. I definitely need to see if I can find the full size. I'm not really fond of like shopping online these days, just because of the way the carriers just really don't care if you get your package or not. So I'm not really a fan of too much shopping online these days. But if I can find it in the store, I definitely get another one. All right, so my next favorite is my Conair Body Shaver. I did a full review on this, so if you haven't seen it, I'll link the video probably up in the iCard or down below in the description box. More than likely, it'll be up in the iCards. But I love this body shaver. I cannot stop using it. I use it nonstop. I like that it has like this little pop-up thing here, just in case you want to trim up your bikini line or whatever you want to trim up. Or even if you're a guy and you want to trim up like this area right here, you can do that. But I love this body shaver. It gets a really nice close shave. Not as close as I would prefer, like if I was to use a disposable razor, but close enough. I mean, it saves a whole lot of time with shaving. So I really, really like this. So like I said, if you want to see the full review, I'll link it down below, either down below or up in here, so you can check that out. But I love that body shaver. Okay, so my next favorite is my Wet n Wild concealers. I love these. Y'all know how much I love these concealers. They're only like $3.99, $2.99 or $3.99, something like that. Super cheap though. I love this. I love coverage. And of course, this is the concealer I'm wearing today. So the one that I'm wearing now is Dark Cocoa. I actually have a couple of other shades too. I have medium deep tan and medium tawny. So I have three different colors. And I bought the other ones just in case, like one day I want to like brighten up any other kind of concealer. I would just use this just to pop it on top. But I really love those concealers. They're super cheap and I feel like you would really enjoy them. So that, being that it's so affordable, I feel like it's worth giving a shot. So my next favorite is my lip liners from NYX. And as you can tell, this thing is super small. I love these lip liners. This one is in the color, let me sharpen this. This is in the color Hot Cocoa. I love this lip liner. I really like this lip liner a whole lot. As you can see, it goes on really nice and smooth. They're only like $3. You can probably even find them cheaper than that. These are just really, really good lip liners. I love them. Every time I go in the beauty supply store, I always forget to get another one, but I definitely need to make a note to make sure that I pick up a couple more extras, because I think somebody commented, said that they couldn't find it. I don't think it's discontinued, because the last time I looked online on the NYX website, they had them on there. So I guess it just depends on where you go. But those are really, really good lip liners. If you don't try anything else, definitely try out those lip liners, because I feel like you will love them. I really, really like them. Okay, so the last thing I'll be talking about is castor oil, and I've been really loving castor oil for my locks. And I feel like my hair has been growing like a weed. I don't know why. Well, I guess because of the castor oil, but my hair seems like it's been growing like crazy. I'm able to get it up in a bun now, and I didn't even expect to even be able to have my hair up in a bun at 7 months. And yeah, I just reached 7 months like a couple of days ago. But I've been oiling my scalp with castor oil, not like every day, but just, I guess, maybe like once a week, maybe twice a week, something like that. But it's not really like a routine or nothing like that. I just put it on it when I feel like it. But the first one I got is the OK brand, and this is the rosemary kind. It's the black Jamaican castor oil, and this one has like the little spout on it. And I don't really care for the smell on this one, so I just really use it. It's not a bad smell, but I just don't really care for this smell. It's not a bad smell, it's just not really a good smell either. But this one is the Jamaican mango and lime Jamaican black castor oil, and this one is Amla. It says Amla right here in the blue bottle. This one really smells good. I like the smell on this one. It smells way better than the other one. So as soon, I think I'm maybe like where, like a little bit less of a half bottle on this one. So once I run out, I definitely just pour this one inside this little bottle, just cause it got the little spout on it. But I love it. It's thick. You know, castor oil is really thick. So I just, sometimes I put it on my scalp, and then I just like to put a little bit like around my edges too. And I do like it because it don't like run all over my face when I'm oiling my scalp. And these days I haven't been really doing much to my edges. But yeah, I've been really loving castor oil. Sometimes what I was doing first, I was mixing it. But I've just, lately I've just been really liking just using it by itself. So yeah, these are the two castor oils that I'm using, and I really, really like them. I really like the smell on this one. But as soon as I'm out on this one, because I don't want to mix them, because I really just want to enjoy the smell of this one on its own. So I want to just go ahead and use this up. And as soon as I'm done, I just pour it in here, and then I'll use this little bottle as my little scalp oiling machine. But anyway, y'all, thank y'all so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next one.